Hi, and welcome to Tiger Art. Today is part 3 of our lesson on ancient Greek patterns and pottery. Today, you will need a few extra materials. You will need some kind of shape of a pot. So you'll have in your art kit 3 pot shapes that I've printed out for you. Pick one of them. You're not going to use all 3. Just pick the one that you like the best. Take a pair of scissors and cut that out. Cut just along the outline of it so that you have a shape that you can trace. You're also going to need your scratch board, which is a black piece of paper that has a shiny coating on it. When you scratch it, the color underneath will show. Be very careful when handling this. If you accidentally rub it against something, it's going to scratch and there will be a mark there and you can't get rid of it. Also be careful with running your hands over it. So if you make a smudge with your finger on the black scratchboard surface, it will be very hard to scratch in that spot. So be careful how you handle it. Handle it by the edges and be careful that you don't make any additional scratches that you don't want. In the end, this project is going to look something like this. So you'll be able to cut out your actual scratchboard after you're done. All right, so for today, we're gonna be getting started on this Greek pot project. This is an example that a fourth grade student made in my class a few years ago. And you can see how they did a really good job. I'm going to show you what steps they took to get theirs to look like this. I've given you an art kit that looks like this for this project. Inside you will find 3 pot shapes that have been copied. You can pick one of those. You also have a black scratchboard paper. And then on the outside you have a little wood stick that you can use. For this project, you will also need some scissors and a pencil. And you will also be needing a pair of scissors. A good thing to have as well would be a ruler. If you have a ruler, you can use that. So pick a pot shape first. Doesn't matter which one it is. Just pick one of them. I'm gonna pick this one. Cut it out carefully. Then you're going to carefully take out your black scratch board. I say carefully because this thing is quite fragile. It's quite delicate. If you accidentally were to rub it against something or just happen to get a little bit of something touching it, it's going to scratch away the black. So what's happening is there's a color underneath and then there's a shiny black layer on top. When you scratch away the black, it shows the color underneath. You're not actually drawing anything onto it. You're actually taking something away from it. So you're gonna trace this pot shape on here, but make it, when you put it down, don't push and slide it across there, because if you do that, like if I did that at the bottom, it's gonna scratch away a big blue line there, and I don't want that. So if you have some stray scratches, it's not the end of the world. Just put the pot somewhere on there where there is no stray scratches. It doesn't matter if it's centered or anything because you're just going to cut it out later anyways. Take the wood stick off the front of your art kit packet. Hold it tight and then very carefully trace the pot shape on the scratch board using the wood stick. Don't cut this out yet until you're all the way done. It makes it a lot easier. It's easier to handle that way. You can grab it out here and you don't have to worry about holding it by the pot itself. If you were to get any fingerprint smudges on here, it would be very hard to scratch. Like if you make a smudge print, it doesn't scratch as well where your finger touched, because the oil from your hands kind of ruins the scratching process. So then you're going to want to divide this up. I told you to make 8 patterns, so you're going to want 8 spots on here at least. First, look for places where it should be split up. Like, it looks like there would probably be a ring across here. So I'm going to use my ruler, setting it down carefully, not letting it slide, and I'm going to just make a line across there. Now I have a shape up here that I could put a Greek pattern into. It also looks like there should probably be a line straight across here. Try to keep your ruler straight. If you don't have a ruler, you could use like the edge of a book or a notebook or something straight that has a hard edge. It also looks like there'd be something right here. So now I have 1, 2, 3, 4 shapes. I need to somehow come up with 4 more, and I think I want them to go at least 4 more. I think I want them to go down here. So by drawing 3 more lines, I end up with 4 more shapes. Now this shape looks too big, so I'm going to split it in half. Remember, the Greek patterns are kind of short and then long. Like short up and down wise, but long side to side. Same thing here. Okay. Navigate over to the patterns that you have made before and start drawing them on here exactly as you had practiced. So let's say you were going to put a pattern across the top here. Remembering what I said about making the pattern solid and not just a line, I'm going to thicken the top and bottom lines. So now it's like a block going across the bottom. It will stand out better and it will look much, much better. It doesn't matter if you accidentally get outside of the lines of this pot, because you will be cutting it out. So feel free to go right to the edge. Then I would draw in here my pattern. And as I'm doing that, I'm trying to make it not just a line, rather solid shapes like this. That way you will see the pattern better. You'll see the opposite pattern that's inside of it. So if you looked at this the right way, if you looked at it upside down, it should look like the same thing, but the black part becomes what the blue was. Going back to my student-made example, you can see how great of a job they did in doing just that. Your assignment for today is to get started on this. You will not finish it all in one day. If you finish it today, you're probably spending more time than you should, or you're doing it wrong and you're trying to go too fast. So take your time, just try to get a little bit of it done. I would shoot for maybe 3 patterns to start.